In our global union, the ITF, we are working together to build stronger transport unions to give workers power. Women are vital in achieving this industrial strength. With declining union membership, globalization, and the economic crisis, trade unions are setting strategic direction for the future and building their power to win for workers. And Sharon Burrow of the International Trade Union Confederation knows from her own experience how women's leadership makes a difference.
There's no doubt that women make a difference. When you have women now almost on equal participation rates to men, almost 50% of the workforce, then having women in unions, having women organising in their workplaces actually builds the numeric base of unions, but it builds the strength of unions.
Dynamic transport unions know they have incredible potential at their fingertips. Global capital depends on global transport. And across transport corridors in multinational companies and global supply chains, ITF unions need women and men to implement strategic plans and build trade union power. Jacqueline Smith of the Norwegian Seafarers Union says that transport unions can transform and get stronger.
A trade union, if it's not dynamic, it's going to be passé. Because the industry, it moves and it changes, mm-hmm. and so does the members in the unions. They need to move and change so that they can adapt to the time and they can adapt to the challenges that continue to face them.
When Anneli Nyberg joined her union, she found other women's support was the key.
I took some small things. I was working in some working groups, and I've been a leader for the cabin union now for 6 years. And there was also, at the time, a very clever woman leading the union. She went a lot of me the first years.
Seema Mohan made a difference in her union by organizing women.
I feel that after attending such type of conferences, I'm looking at the point of leadership from a different angle, and I feel there are many qualities which I can correct upon so that I can work towards it while organizing at my workplace.
Zipporah Maini from Kenya also benefited from the struggles of other women in her union.
To get here, we've had to fight as women. The chair, who is in the national office, went there ahead of us. So she kind of prepared the way for us, and yeah, that's how we got it.
Gemeni Maria Gonzalez from Argentina says that women organizing themselves within the unions is the answer.
Women, representative of women, must organization, and then present the project, the serious project, because if we wait for the times of demand, we can wait a few years.
The ITF's Vice President, Brigitte Paas, thinks that unions must take action to bring women into decision making.
My union was emancipated enough to say, look, we have a good woman, so she's going to get the position. Women are 51% of the world's population. And if you don't have women within your sections, and you don't allow women to do the jobs, then you will have a major problem.
And times have indeed changed. In transport unions, women's membership and participation is growing fast. For the ITF, supporting unions who want to develop their women members is key. The ITF's Women's Committee has focused on promoting this work. Alison McGarry, the ITF Women's Coordinator, aims to develop union potential via the Federation's Women's Leadership Programme.
We're going to be talking a lot in the week about lighting fires, about leadership as proactive. And there's the definition. It's a verb, it's an action verb. But of course, action, being very clear about what the targets, what the outcomes that we want to achieve are.
ITF women can and do make a difference. Unions who want to grow must build the capacity of women members and enable women leaders to take our movement forward. It's time to win for workers, women and men. So get on board with the ITF Women's Leadership Programme and be part of something big.